Hello and welcome everyone, I am Chintan and in this video today we are going to take a look at how to model this pavilion inside of Sketchup. So this pavilion was designed by Studio Gang's architects and this is located in Chicago at the Lincoln Park Zoo. So let's take a look at how to model this inside of Sketchup. Let's go. Okay, so let's begin by drawing a line. Draw a line for 900 mm. Now using this line and from its midpoint, draw another line for 900 mm as well. Now using these lines as reference, make a triangle like this. Now you can delete the middle line as we don't need it. Now select this triangle and rotate it a copy using the rotate tool, that is Q, and delete the line in the middle. Now select this and make this whole shape a component by right clicking and creating component. Now drag a copy of this component using the move tool and the control key, and similarly drag a copy of both of these and type 6x on your keyboard to make 6 copies. Now select both of these rows and make 9 copies using the move tool in a similar way. So hit the M key, use the control key and type 9x on your keyboard. Now delete these rows as we don't need them and you should have a pattern like this. Now double click to edit any component. So I can select this and using the arc tool, the shortcut for which is A, make an arc like this. And on the other side similarly, draw another arc like this. Now using the other components as reference, paste these arcs like this. Similarly, we need to drag a copy of these arcs like this and over here. Now using the line tool, draw these two lines so that it creates a surface. Now drag a copy of this component and place it on the side and clean up the component. So delete these lines and these lines as well. Now using the offset tool, the shortcut for which is F, offset this face and delete the middle part. Now using the push-pull tool, pull this face upwards. You should have a component like this. Now to create the inner covering, we need to select this edge. So select this edge carefully and copy this and paste it in place. So the shortcut I have set for that is Ctrl Shift plus V. Now with that being selected, make that a component using the G key, and now edit and right click that edge and weld it. If you don't have the weld command in your Sketchup, you can use the TIG weld plugin. Now rotate copies of this by 30 degrees and type in 6x so that we get 6 copies. Now to create a surface using these lines, use the sandbox tools so that we have the surface. We can give this a glass material so that it becomes transparent. Now select this component and paste it in the main component like this. Now you should have something that looks like this. Now we need to delete the inner component in the both rows on each side. Select these two rows and make them unique and delete the inner component like this. I have set the shortcut D for delete. That select these rows and make them unique by right clicking and delete this inner component. Now you should have something that looks like this. Now select everything and make this whole thing a single group. I have set up the shortcut Ctrl plus G for group. If you don't have that, you can set it up. If you want all my shortcuts, there's a link down below. You can download the shortcut files in a PDF from Gumroad. Now we just need to bend this using the shapebender plugin. It's a free plugin. You can get it from the Sketchup warehouse. So the plugin requires a line that's parallel to the group and an arc or any line that we need to bend the group around. So draw an arc of radius 4500 mm and turn on the shapebender plugin. So the icon looks like this. Select the group, click on the straight line and then on the curve. That should take some time and project how the final shape would look like. To flip it, use the arrow keys and press enter to finalize your shape. Now we just need to rotate this. Rotate this by 90 degrees. Now we don't need these. We can delete this. We can place it over the origin. Something that I like to do. And we can also delete this component. Close this. Now the basic form of the pavilion is ready. I can paint it using the paint bucket tool. For the thumbnail, I like this color, so I'm painting it. If you want to make this longer, you can drag a copy of this using the move tool and place it over here. So now this becomes twice as long, and we are basically done. So I'll just turn on the shadows. This looks good. If you want to add some context, you can go to the 3D warehouse, add some trees, some vegetation, some people. So what I like to do is add 2D people just to add some sort of a scale context to the diagram or the image. So I'll search for 2D people. And you can place it. I'll just place it randomly over here. And that's, we are done. So if you learned something from the video, please subscribe. If you have any doubts, you can join our Discord server or leave them in the comments. And the next video, we'll learn something even better. So stay tuned and I'll see you in the next one.